Hallo und willkommen zurück. Heute wieder Dream Daily. Was auch sonst gerade. Ich meine, läuft ja ganz gut. Genau, ich habe meinen Cursor verloren. Nein, so. Ich habe ja die Nacht davor aufgehört, beziehungsweise wir sind in der Nacht ja schon drin gewesen und jetzt sind wir am nächsten Morgen. Und für mein kleines Anzeigebild da unten habe ich heute einen Hintergrund eingestellt, einfach um es auszuprobieren. Muss man auch nicht weiter beachten. Okay, dann geht's jetzt los. I definitely didn't sleep well last night. I brew some strong coffee and make some scrambled eggs for Amanda as a peace offering. She eventually wanders into the kitchen. Hey. I thought about what you said last night. I should have texted you. I said I was gonna do it and I didn't. I honestly just didn't even think about it. I'm really sorry, Pops. I won't do it again. Oh, guter Zug. Well, I'm sorry for freaking out on you. I trust you to make good choices. Good. Oh, das ist schon hart. Okay, I trust you to make good choices. I also thought about it and I'll try to give you your space from here on out. I gotta trust that you can take care of yourself. Team Smith? Team Smith. Just for your information, ich habe die, ja, Smith mit Nachnamen getauft. Amanda gives me a hug. Want some eggs? You know it. Sprinkle some cheese on them. Oh, das mag ich auch gerne. Already did. Bless you. Amanda scarfs down the eggs and the time it takes me to wash the pan. All right, I'm off to school. Smell you later. Wait, one more thing before you go. What? What's that book? Ja, stimmt, da war ja was. Wir wurden ja eingeladen, zu Dad Book zu kommen. It's a social media platform. Wait. What? What's a social media platform? Ich finde, der Dad-Humor ist einfach großartig. Dad, I have to go to school. Come on, Amanda, I'm an old man. I can't put together a Dad-Book profile on my own. Alright, I'll help you sound interesting on the internet. Ah, jetzt habe ich es verstanden. Amanda spends the next couple minutes setting up my profile on Dad-Book, which as it turns out, is a place where dads can get together and talk about fatherhood. Imagine, das wäre ein realer Service. Wow. Alright, Pops, we gotta fill out your profile. Let's get some likes and dislikes. Jetzt kommt's. Okay, jetzt wird's interessant. On a Friday night, you're most likely to polish and sort my coin collection. Netflix and grill, baby. Fall asleep watching the History Channel. Torment my children with dad puns. Sink into blissful oblivion, aka sleep. Okay. Torment my children with dad puns. Das finde ich gut. If you had one thing to take with you onto a desert island, what would it be? My trusty grill. Oh man. The Lost Shaker of Salt. Cast away on DVD for instructional purposes. Das finde ich richtig gut. A boat, obviously. I don't need anything. My survival skills have trained me for this day. A boat. Ich würde auch ein Boot mitnehmen. What are your turn-ons? Strong dad arms. Tennis shoes with long white socks. Oh mein Gott. A well-manicured lawn. Street smarts. Street smarts? Whatever that is supposed to be. Top-tier grillmanship. Comfortable with crying. Okay, wir nehmen mal die strong dad arms. What did you want to be when you grew up? Technical writer for manuals and instructionals. Salty boat captain. Pro skater who is also an astronaut. A good father. The president of space. Oh, das finde ich gut. The president of space. What's your favorite movie genre? War documentaries. Sean Connerys entire filmography. Ich muss sagen, da bin ich auch ein bisschen dabei. Anything on Laserdisc, romantic comedies, whatever will make me cry. Old comedies that haven't aged well. Oh, yeah, da gibt's einige von. Ja, dann nehmen wir den Sean Connery. What's your ideal date? Napping together. Doing a 1000-piece puzzle together. Eating a healthy dinner at 4 p.m. Oh my god. Trying to geocache but getting hopelessly lost? Arson. Oh wow. Being emotionally vulnerable. Über dieses Wort stolper ich ständig, also. Okay, trying to geocache but getting hopelessly lost. What do you never leave home without? A sensible cardigan? My sick vape? My book of word jumbles and a pen? A cool knife? My cripplingly low self-esteem? Ach, komm schon. I frequently forget my phone keys and wallet at home. Sometimes. I frequently forget my phone keys and wallet at home. Sometimes. Das ist verwirrend. Okay, what do you never leave home without? Ich würde sagen, a cool knife. I spend a lot of time thinking about conspiracy theories. How proud I am of my child. Potential ends of the world. If I'll ever be able to love myself as much as I love my grill. Kannst echt alles auf Grill hier irgendwie ausbauen. When I can next get a cup of coffee, lawn mower modifications. How proud I am of my child. Profile complete. Oh, it's entspannt. See, that wasn't so bad. Yeah, that was actually kind of fun. I could totally spend all day on here just looking at people's profiles. You should message one of them, or more than one of them. All of these dads seem pretty interesting. Okay, I promise I'll make some friends. Wie oft hat er das jetzt schon versprochen? Amanda gives me a hug. Go get him, Dad. Oh, Dad book, here I come.
You've got dads.
You've got dads. Was ist das hier? Eine Nachricht von Amanda als Dad verkleidet? Dad Manda. Hi Lloyd, it's me, your dear old friend from way back in the day, Dad Manda. I'm delighted to see you've signed up for Dadbook. They've recently added this exciting new messenger service, so you may find yourself receiving messages from other dads, like myself. Take care not to miss them. Write a message. Amanda, is that you? What are you doing on Dadbook? Why, Lloyd, I never. We've known each other since business school. How could you possibly confuse me for your amazing and talented and easy to buy things for daughter? Though I am, of course, flattered. You should buy Amanda more things. Amanda, you know I didn't go to business school. I barely even managed to get my degree. Wait. No. Wow. I didn't say that. You never heard that. This is gold. I was a great student, I swear. I graduated at the top of my class because I worked hard and ate all my vegetables. Totally holding on to this for later. Wait, do you even remember what I majored in? I declined to comment. Cool. Conversation ended. Okay, Dead Manda, here we go. Good, we have Craig, Matt, Brian, Robert, Damien, Hugo and Joseph. Ja, wen nehmen wir denn als erstes? Versuchen wir es bei Robert, weil da haben wir ja schon ein bisschen mehr Erfahrung. Ah, wir können auch einfach nur erstmal die Profile gucken. Ah, schön. Alles klar, Robert Small. When the internet gains sentience and decides to destroy us all, you know it'll use this information against us, right? Okay, on a Friday night you're most likely to make a deal in an alleyway, have it go badly. Who's the cop? Was it Giacomo? I trust Giacomo. If you had one thing to take with you on a desert island, what would it be? Gun. So dramatisch. What are your turn-ons? Don't talk to me. What did you want to be when you grew up? Grifter. Okay, gucken wir in die anderen auch mal rein. Break. Break can. Can, can't, can, ja. You get it. Debt-free business entrepreneur and fitness enthusiast. Juggling work, family and fitness is a tough gig, but sometimes gotta do it. Someone's. Nicht sometimes. Someone's. On a Friday night, you're most likely to get one last good cardio session in. If you had one thing on for a desert island, a box of energy bars. What are your turn-ons? A sub 6 minute mile. A sub 6, okay. What did you want to be when you grew up? Beer Pong World Champion. Oh, da geht's ja noch weiter. What's your favorite movie genre? Buddy Cop Movies. Stimmt, ich habe mir das auch alles ausgefüllt. What's your ideal date? Scaling a huge dangerous mountain for fun. What do you never leave home without? An extra tube of energy gel. I spent a lot of time thinking about my mile time used to be so good. What happened? Have I peaked? Wow, okay. Dann gucken wir das bei Robert eben auch noch fertig. What's your favorite movie genre? Italian neorealism. What's your ideal date? Grave robbing. Oh my god. What do you never leave home without? At least 4 knives. Dann haben wir ja schon eine Gemeinsamkeit. Wobei, ich glaube, ich hatte das woanders. Egal. I spend a lot of time thinking about. You ever really look into a rabbit animal's eyes? Alles klar. Okay, Matt. Avid music enthusiast, passionate coffee drinker. You can find me most days selling bean juice over at the Coffee Spoon or hanging out at the park with my amazing daughter. Hit me up about 80s no wave music. Okay, Friday night. Perfect my cold brew setup. One drip at a time, baby. The desert island. Fine tunes to pass the days away. Turn-ons. Multi-instrumentalism. Das ist ein interessantes Wort. Grew up dream, a barista, weirdly enough. Favorite movie genre? Shit with subtitles. Also anime? What's the ideal date? We go to the animal shelter and seriously consider adopting a cat. Finde ich gut. What do you never leave home without? My headphones, both in-ear and over-ear, just in case. Oh yeah, a double power. A lot of time thinking about where did writing commas into song titles come from and where did it go? Did we all just agree that it's a bad idea? Okay, yes, self-music. Brian. Hey, I'm Brian. I spend most of my days hanging out with my awesome daughter and thinking up new ways to grow things. If you like fishing, then we'll get along. Okay, Friday night. See just how slowly I can cook a piece of brisket. Desert Island, my fishing pole. Turn-ons. A keen understanding of steak cuts. Ich glaube, ist der Griller. what do you what did you want to be when you grew up? Fireman. Favorite movie genre? Romantic comedies. Ideal day? Deck building. Yeah, deck building finde ich gar nicht so schlecht. What do you never leave home without? Portable fishing pole. And a lot of time thinking about how my daughter is smarter than I am. Ja, die ist wirklich krass intelligent. Damien. How do you do? I have finally decided to join this information superhighway. I'm not entirely sure how this works, but I will try my best to understand. I love long strolls through graveyards and spending time with my son. If you would ever like to chat about the latest in Victorian fashion, the inevitability of our own demise, or black cats, please send me a letter. A letter. Oh my god. Friday night. Listen to true crime podcasts while I taxidermy my new specimens. Taxidermy? Kenn das Wort leider nicht. Desert Island? A coffin. Natürlich. Ich hab dich auch sofort als Vampir abgestempelt, Damien. Turnouts. Pronouncing Bossum correctly. Bossum. Oh, Bossum. 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 I'm sorry, Damien. What do you want to be when you grew up? A bat. Favorite movie genre? Foreign arthouse horror. Ideal date. It's night. We are at an industrial dark wave club in Berlin. The music drums to the beat of our hearts. Fancy? What do you never leave home without? An upside down cross. Ja, so sieht er aus. Sorry, aber es ist einfach dieser Archetyp. I spend a lot of time thinking about mortality salience. Okay, Hugo. Wie hieß Brian eigentlich mit Nachnamen? Harding. Brian Harding und Matt Seller. Okay. Hugo. Hugo Vega. middle school teacher, high school teacher, writer of scholarly articles on 18th century literature for various esteemed publications. If you're on here to tell me that my son put a cherry bomb in your trash, I know, and I'm sorry. Well, Friday night, brew some strong tea and paint my miniatures. Desert Island, remembrance of things passed by... Of things passed by Marcel Proust or Proust? Turnouts, muscles. What did you want to be when you grew up? Movie star. Favorite movie genre? Documentaries on art history. Ideal date. Each of us read a different book on opposite sides of the couch in comfortable silence. I mean, warum nicht? Es ist ja auch sehr schön, einfach nur mal zu sitzen, runterzukommen und ein echt gutes Buch zu lesen. Okay, what do you never leave home without? My glasses. Actually, I forgot them at home a lot. Forget them at home a lot, so. I spend a lot of time thinking about. I worry that people who are against e-readers are more in love with the idea of books than actually reading them. Oh, shots fired. Okay, und zu guter Letzt, Joseph Christensen. Voted Mabel Blaise number one youth minister for 5 years running. Living in my hometown with my beautiful wife and our 4 amazing kids. If I'm not in church, you can catch me out on the open water, setting sail on the seas of adventure. I love playing guitar and crushing my kids at Candyland. Ja, wenn man so viele Kinder hat. Okay, Friday night. Lead the community in a fun mixer. Das klingt irgendwie falsch für mich so als deutsche Person. If you had one thing, Desert Island, my sixth string, schön, turn-ons, my loving wife. What did you want to be when you grew up? Ship captain. What's your favorite movie genre? Feel-good movies. Ideal date, lovely night on the town with my wife. What do you never leave home without? The good book. Ich weiß, welches Buch ihr meint. I spend a lot of time thinking about how I can be a better man, husband and father. Er ist ja der Einzige in der Runde, der wirklich in einer Beziehung ist, beziehungsweise sogar verheiratet. Zumindest von dem, was man schon rausgehört hat. Bei den anderen weiß man es nicht oder es ist ziemlich deutlich, wie bei Robert zum Beispiel. Aber gut, ich schreibe jetzt Robert. Genau das hatte ich vor. Message. Mal schauen, was passiert. Ah, erstmal ein Schlückchen trinken. Cheers. Ah, okay. Robert was pretty nice. A little odd, but nice. Ruggedly handsome. We should hang out. I type out a message to him on Dadbook. Let's go. Hey Robert, good seeing you again at the cookout. Wanna grab a drink? I sit there for a couple seconds hoping he'll message me back. Let's wait. Hey, it says that he read my message. Wow. I anxiously wait for a response. Twiddle my thumbs. Watch cat videos on the internet. I start down a rabbit hole of cat videos and Robert quickly vanishes from my mind. I didn't realize how long I've been doing this, but by the time I watch maybe my 30th cat video, Robert pops back into my head. Es kommt jetzt drauf an, wie lang die Cat-Videos sind oder waren. Das kann sehr viel Zeit oder auch sehr wenig sein. I jump back over to Dadbook to see if he's responded yet. Nothing. Well, I guess the guy's busy. I might as well make the best of my day. Wow. Das war schon ein sehr guter Start mit ihm, ja. Auch auf Dadbook natürlich. I get up, walk to the living room, then sit down and turn on the TV. History Channel, Food Channel, Game Show. Oh ja, Game Show. Ooh, Family Fortunes on. Alright, Nicole, your parents are in the lead and it's up to you to win it big. Are you ready? I'm ready! They hook the contestant up to a lie detector in front of her parents. Who is your favorite parent? My mom? Ooh, sorry, incorrect. Next question. If both of your parents were hanging off the edge of a cliff, which would you save? This is terrible. I love it. Ich bin ja auch so ein Trash-TV-Gucker. Da gibt's immer richtig lustige Sachen. I lose several hours to whatever the hell it was. Sighing, I get up and walk around the house. My stomach rumbles. Time for lunch, huh? Well, I guess it's time for old Chef Smith to cook a gourmet delicacy. Alright. I walk over to the refrigerator and open the door. Make a sandwich, microwave some eggs. Ooh. Ist das a thing? Ich meine, macht man das wirklich? Ich würde sowas nie tun. Mama's Toucher. Einfach so, oh, lecker Senf. Wir machen natürlich ein proper Sandwich. I make a sandwich in its entirety while standing there. Who needs plates? The sandwich, a lost art. I admire my work for a second before I clumsily drop the entire thing on the floor. No, the good sandwich. No. I look around and remember that Amanda's not home. This is still good. 5 second rule, right? Das ist eine Lüge, just saying. I reassemble my sandwich, peeling pickles off the floor and putting them back where they belong, in my mouth. Wait, I'm a wreck. I finish my snack and walk around the house some more bored. When's Amanda coming home? Oh, I just remembered something. Ich frag mich gerade, hat er keinen Job? Gehst du nicht arbeiten, Junge? Bist du einfach nur Single Dad und cool damit? Wer braucht schon Geld? Okay. When we were packing up the old house, we found an old basketball hoop that would hang off a door. It would really bring the living room together. I wonder where I put that. Alright, I spend a couple of minutes poking around the new place until I find it. After installing it above one of the doors in the living room, I'm ready to dunk. Let's go. Come on and slam! I take a leap from the free throw line and rocket that sucker down the net. The crowd goes wild. Woo! And welcome to the jam! I pull up from the 3-point line, breaking ankles and sinking a fadeaway. And I forgot the rest of the words of the song. Ich tatsächlich gerade auch. Nein, fällt mir nicht mehr ein. Space Jam ist mir bekannt, aber mir fällt dazu nichts ein. No look behind the back hookshot. Everyone's on their feet. Something, something Space Jam. Dad? I turn around to see Amanda standing in the doorway. Her eyes are a little puffy. Almost as if she'd been crying. Oder ein Tütchen geraucht. Hey Amanda Panda, you alright? What are you doing? I'm fine. Oh mein Gott. Hat sie einen Schnupfen oder ist sie wirklich crying? I found the hoop and I'm taking it to the hole. Pass me the rock. Laser the ball to Amanda. Granny toss the apple. Put up a brick. Laser the ball to Amanda. I lead the league in blocks. Geil. Set the record for rebounds in my rookie year. Think you can handle this? What's a rebound? Ich habe ja früher auch viel Basketball geguckt und auch ein bisschen gespielt und... Ja, man muss es nicht kennen. Oh, when someone misses a shot and the other players try to retrieve it, that's just kidding! Amanda zigzags past me and tips the layout into the hoop. Hab ich so viel Platz da drin, ey? Wow, riesiges Wohnzimmer. Out of war, bitches. Amanda, language. Sun Tzu didn't care about language. Sun Tzu wahrscheinlich. I would argue that Sun Tzu cared very much about language, so once you write something as timeless as The Art of War, then you're allowed to swear. Nah. Amanda sticks out her tongue and dunks for another 2 points. Seriously though, are you okay? You look like you've been crying. Oh, dude, I'm cool. I just saw like this really cute dog on the way home and it let me pet its belly. I couldn't contain my emotions. Ich fühle das so sehr. Are you sure that that's all you're upset about? You have to tell me what's actually wrong. Tell me more about this dog. Jawohl. Gladly. Oh, ich habe Herzchen von dir gekriegt. Schön. She was a little French bulldog named Jacqueline. Jacqueline? And her tongue was permanently stuck out of her mouth. She had a little sweater on. Well, I probably also would have cried if I got to pet her. She was so excited for tummy rubs. Oh no, I'm tearing up just thinking about it. But seriously. You know you can talk to me about anything, right? Yeah, that's why I'm talking about my love for French bulldogs with you. Okay, just remember that it's okay to be sad. And also remember that I love you very much. And only want what's best for you. That's all. Huh. Alright, jeez, don't make me cry again. Oh, okay, just making sure. Maybe you should be less concerned with my face and more concerned with full-court press. Yeah, schön. Amanda and I played ball for a little longer, then we cooked dinner together. We managed to not almost burn down the house this time. Afterward, Amanda and I dig into a carton of ice cream over an episode of Chopped Toddler Tournament. Ey, die Namen der Serien oder Filme da in diesem Spiel ist großartig. What you have in front of you is a molecularly deconstructed sweet potato with a brown sugar demi glaze with cream fraiche, of course. This is literally a jar of baby food. The toddler immediately bursts into tears. Huh? Are we bad people for watching this? Yes. After a few more episodes, Amanda goes to bed. I check my computer one last time. Still nothing from Robert Everhead's erwartet. But it says he read my message. Is he ignoring me? Eventually, I climb into bed to get some rest, but I just can't stop wondering why Robert won't message me back. Tja, da haben wir ja echt, Date complete. Das war unser Dad, Date, nicht Dad, Dad Date. Better. C-Rank. Ja gut. Was haben wir denn hier so alles? Energy Saving. Ziemlich hoch. Respect. Ja, gut über die Hälfte. Crime. Auch ziemlich hoch. Whiskey. White Wine. Bad Ideas. Okay. Dad Points. 384. Daddy Points. Viel zu viele. Gut, ich frage mich, was das zu bedeuten hat, aber das wird sich wahrscheinlich noch mit der Zeit erklären. Click to continue. Oh, ich habe hier etwas bekommen. Knife Dad. Okay. Gut, dann soll es das erstmal gewesen sein, bis hierhin. Wir haben jetzt... Sprechen. Wir haben jetzt Robert über Dad Book angeschrieben, aber er hat natürlich nicht geantwortet. Und mal sehen, was es damit auf sich hat, ob wir da noch irgendwie an ihn rankommen. Er ist sowieso der mysteriöseste von allen. Aber ja, dann machen wir hier an dieser Stelle beim nächsten Mal direkt weiter und dann gucken wir mal, ja, was da noch so kommt. Ich meine, wir können ja bestimmt auch zwischendurch den anderen Dads schreiben oder mit denen irgendwas machen. Das ist immerhin ein Dating-Simulator. Okay, alles klar. Dann ich wünsche euch eine gute Zeit und habt Spaß. Bis dann. Ciao.